Get ready to match the star. Dick Gauthier. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Riley. Belinda Fee. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Body Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you. Thank you, Johnny Olson, and dear friends and gentle hearts. Everybody ready?
Yes, sir.
Now, you look ready to me. Well, shall we plow on then and say hello to our two players?
Is there a carnival in town?
No, there isn't.
Just inquire.
Yes, sir.
Our friends.
Katie Heintz and Sedalia Jones. Applause, applause, applause. Katie's the current champ. Now, this lady has won two games, but she's had some tough luck when she gets up there, so that she has only a total of $300, but that's better than nothing. Okay, and she's being challenged by Sedalia, who had a remarkably successful first round with matching all six of our celebrities. And now you've got another shot at tying her and going to a tiebreaker. That's the best you can hope for. We'll see if it happens right after we see about this. Ready, here we go. All right, Katie, since Sedalia's matched all six celebrities, you got your choice here of A or B in round two.
B.
All right. Everybody plays?
Okay.
Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I'm
going to have to rehearse that a little more. I think they're going to, yes.
First time they've been together.
Oh, that's right.
Excellent.
Right. First, not bad for a first
very
time.
Very proud of you.
She's so dumb that she put a blank on a leg of lamb.
Oh, my goodness me.
Dumb Dora is so dumb that she put a blank on a leg of lamb. That's how dumb Dumb Dora was.
I'll bet she was, too. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
She's been drinking the ink again.
Dumb Dora so dumb. Okay, here we go. Katie Heintz. They're
one
all
second.
Finished over there. Oh, change your mind.
Poor devil.
Ready.
Wild horses wouldn't get it out of me.
Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I tell you how dumb she is, Katie. She put a blank on a leg of lamb.
Well, how about a sweater made out of wool? You know. Well, lambs have wool, and so she put on...
Do you often
a sweater.
Put a sweater on your leg?
Yeah.
Sweater on a leg? You ever wear your sweater on your leg?
Okay, pants.
No, too late.
Sweater.
Sweater.
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay, Dick, she said, sweater.
I know she did, Gene.
That's do a you wear for Aloha.
Do you wear sweaters on your legs?
No.
I'd like to see that. I said pantyhose.
Pantyhose. So that means Sedalia Jones wins today.
Thank
what
you.
The rest of you?
Yeah.
Hold them up. Okay, socks, socks. All right.
Come on, everybody.
Please stand by for a moment or so while we say goodbye to Katie Heintz here. And thank her for being with us. She's got her $300. We wish her the very best of luck in the completion of her college studies. Katie
thank
Heintz,
you.
$300 for you. Goodbye. How do you feel? No. Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath, Sedalia. Breathe deeply. In and out. In. Out. I'm hyperventilating. I'm fainting. All right. Now, Sedalia, here we go, where you can win over $5,000 in the Big Money Supermatch. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Jack of blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, $250 for the next one, and $100 for the bottom one. Three of them are permitted to assist. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Richard?
Jack of all trades.
Jack of all trades.
Master of none.
Okay.
Brett? I'm thinking of all those cards. What about Jack of... What about Jack of hearts?
Jack of hearts? Fine.
And Melinda?
Melinda.
Jack of spades.
Jack of spades? Is that what you want to say? So you have two card tricks there, Jack of Spades and Jack of Hearts. And you also have the Jack of All Trades. You want one of those, or have you got a better one in your head?
Jack of All Trades.
Jack of All Trades is what you want. That's Richard's answer. Let's find out if it's up there. And if so, where? Let's begin down at the bottom. And reveal, if you would, sir, the $100 response. Jack of spades. That's the one that Melinda gave
Worth you. Every penny.
Worth every penny. That may be a good omen for you, Sedalia. Let's climb up the ladder now and find out if Jack of all trades is under the $250 response. Jack of hearts. Okay. That's two out of three that they gave you. Here's the last chance for Jack of all trades. May we see the $500 number? Hey. See? Didn't it help you to take a deep breath? Take another deep breath. Good for you, Sedalia. You got a total of $600 now. But since you won the $500, that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000 to collect. You got to match one of them head-to-head exactly.
Richard.
Okay. I'll keep it a secret, because we got to let him know. All right, you face me, Sedalia. Richard, you get ready to write, and here we go. Worth $5,000. Blank. Crush. C-R-U-S-H. Finished. Now we ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his for $5,000. What do you say to that, Sedalia? Blank, crush.
Orange.
Orange? They're rooting for you. They're with you. Okay, we'll find out now if you'll match, Richard. Show and tell time, Richard, for $5,000.
Well, black is beautiful.
But orange is absolutely delightful.
$5,600. Isn't that wonderful? All right, you got somebody out there rooting for you?
No.
No? Oh, yes, you have. You got a lot of friends in the studio audience. Well, Sedalia, we're going to give you a chance to cool up and get it all together here while we meet and talk to your next player, competitor, Ellen Rowe. Okay. Hi, Ellen. You know Sedalia. You're very happy for her, aren't you?
Oh, sure.
Well, we're happy for her, too. Now, Ellen, please tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm married to my husband, Dennis. We've been married for 6 years, and we're expecting our first baby in a short while.
What time is it?
And I'm a dental assistant.
You're a dental assistant.
Yes.
In a matter of weeks or months, are you expecting your baby?
About a month and a half.
About a month and a half. All right, good luck with that marvelous, blessed event, and good luck here, Ellen. We'll start this game after we start this message for you. We are ready. I'll push the button, reveal our first round questions, and ask Ellen to make her selection.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Everybody plays. New game. Hey, you may not know this, but before they burned Joan of Arc at the stake, they blanked her.
Oh. Keep America tiny.
Yes, of course. Before they burned Joan of Arc at the stake, they blanked her. Didn't know that, did you? Before they burned Joan of Arc at the stake, they blanked her.
I'm not crazy about that question.
That's a crazy about my answer.
Well, that's a very interesting question. Yes.
Why is that?
Because there are a couple of good choices there.
Yes, there are.
I think I have one.
I don't
really.
Mm-hmm.
Let me just take a peek.
No.
Yeah. That's one of the good choices.
Total surprise. No, that's a bad.
Yes, very good.
Not bad.
Very
not bad.
Good. Everybody ready over there? Ready on the right, ready on the Ellen Rowe. Are you ready? Whoops, I dropped the thing. Ellen, you may not know this, but that's before they burned Joan of Arc at the stake, they blanked her.
Poured gasoline on her.
Well, maybe they had gasoline in those days.
They didn't have, Joan of, didn't have gasoline in those days.
No.
Okay, well, she said gasoline. What did you say?
Gasoline.
Papa.
That's terrible. I said basted her, then she'd
basted
be delicious.
Her. Yeah, that's it.
Have you ever had them like that?
Yeah.
Have you ever had a St. Cook? They're just wonderful.
What do you say, Brett?
I hope that baby goes up for adoption is what I say after that.
Oh,
I said they stuffed her.
They stuffed her. So So far, Joan of Arc is basted and stuffed.
And buttered.
And buttered. What are you going to do to that poor girl?
Well, she could have been basted with gasoline.
No. No. So she's basted, buttered, and stuffed. Richard?
Before you serve that.
Yes.
Filet of Joan.
Yes.
You always season her.
Season her.
Relax.
A saint for all seasons. Yes.
Right. I marinated her. Seasoned what do you say?
Oh, she was a single lady. I don't care for this entire question.
You don't?
I really know.
Well,
but they
it was
said,
quite
gee, Joan, you're a nice girl, and we're sorry to have to do this. They kind of buttered her up.
They buttered her up, yeah. Okay, Helen, let's see how Sedalia does with her first round question. The Godfather said...
Yeah? This is... You know why I talk this way? Because every night before I go to bed, I gargle with blank. That's why I talk this way. Every night before I go to bed, I gargle with blank.
Gotcha.
You two better get married. You're gonna marry that girl. I don't know.
That's it. That's exactly what I was
waiting for. Is that really it?
Okay, are you Charles ready? And they're ready down here. And we're ready over here. Sedalia. The Godfather said,
well, that's what
you know
why
I talk this way? It's because every night before I go to bed, I gargle with
blood.
With blood?
I don't know. She said, I gargle with blood. I don't know if that'll make you talk funny. What do you say,
Dick? With blood? No, I've never done that before. But I may. Gargle with blood. Terrible.
No, as a matter of fact, I said gargle with gravel.
With gravel. That'll make you talk funny.
Thank you.
All right. Brett.
I looked at his answer, and I thought he said granola. And I
granola.
It's healthy for you.
Oh, my
eyes. Can't see either, can you?
Oh, cannot have seen her. I still thought it would be something really hot. You know what I mean, hon? So I said Tabasco sauce.
Tabasco sauce would make him talk funny, Charles?
He would take a glass of turpentine.
That'd make him talk funny?
But only use half of the glass of turpentine. Don't
Melinda
you want
B.
to know why he
Wait,
wouldn't
why?
Use the
why
other
he,
half?
Use half?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Trepentine.
Why would he only use the half?
Well, he would throw the other half on his statue of Joan of Arc.
Oh, okay.
Not worth it, Charles. No. Not worth it at all.
Nice try.
I loved it.
Go to Melinda Fee. Cut to Melinda
okay,
Fee's face.
Well,
Fee's face.
When you talk like that, the only thing I can think of is cotton. Cotton mouth.
Cotton mouth.
Garlic.
Well, no one's really come to my answer yet. And now, sir, you.
Why didn't you come to me before? Gargle with paint thinner.
Paint thinner.
A sad end, but a beautiful finish.
Betty White.
These are good.
I have the other half of the glass of turpentine.
How come nobody said acid?
I was
like
that on television.
Oh, you can say acid on camera, can't you? Is that what you said, audience? Yeah. Acid would make your talk funny, right?
I don't like acid.
Okay.
An
and around one, we ain't got nothing here. Nothing showing here. Nothing showing here.
Okay, now
something showing there, though, but we'll get that's another story. We'll go to round two here, but first we got to do a little business. America, this is it. Okay, we're ready to carry on, and we go to round two here and ask Ellen to make her selection.
Be again.
Here we go again.
First you
Bill said,
be again.
I moved into my new custom-built home yesterday. It's terrific.
How terrific is his
home? Well, it's pretty good, except it's terrific except for one thing. The blank is on the roof. Blank is on the roof.
That's
what
a
snack.
Shame.
You got it. Ready for you, Charles. No artwork, Charles. Just a simple response. All right. Ellen Rowe. Bill said, I moved to my new custom-built home yesterday, and it's terrific, except for one thing. The blank is on the roof.
Toilet.
I've never heard such a ear-splitting scream when she said that word.
Toilet got a standing ovation.
Yes. Did you guys have to go badly or something like that? What's wrong with you? Okay. All right. What do you say?
Oh, toilet is so tacky, you could have phrased it euphemistically instead of said John or Lou or something.
That's the toilet!
That. Okay, Ellen, you can keep the baby, dear. I said John.
That's two for Ellen. Charles?
I said toilet.
Toilet. He said toilet.
John?
John. Custom-built home is terrific, except for one thing. The toilet is on the roof.
Well, of course, I use French. Toilet.
Toilet.
Now, we
Got
come to
toilets here for the
Madame.
Girl pipers.
My Uncle Jack, in all seriousness, used to get so upset about it always being referred to as the John. We fixed that. We used to call him Uncle Toilet. It's John.
John it is. You know what you have to do? You got to match everybody to achieve a tie. Six.
Or she'll go right in the... Oh,
she'll go right into the... Sorry about this, Adelia. When Snow White goes camping... Snow White, she has a strange way of starting a fire. She rubs her blanks together. That's what Snow White does.
I have the...
Right?
Four.
Okay, everybody ready? All right. Everybody ready? Sedalia. When Snow White goes camping...
Okay, I just
call him
Shh!
Quiet!
Don't look at me. I was as silent as Sam.
I'm not looking at you.
Woman dying here, you say quiet? How crass can you be? Let me handle this.
Quiet!
Okay.
Oh. Please carry on. I'm sorry.
Whatever happened to bless you?
Oh, that's another show.
When Snow White goes camping, she has a strange way of starting a fire. She rubs her blanks together.
Knees.
You know who Snow White is? You know who Snow Black is? Yeah. Snow White. All right, now wait a minute. In a moment, you will see.
Snow White and the Seven Knees.
Snow White and the Seven Knees.
Very well-known show.
All right, got to match everybody to stay in the game. Sedalia, Dick.
She rubs her knees together? Okay. No, I said the obvious thing, rubs her dwarves together.
No, that means Ellen wins again. What's the rest of you have?
Dwarves! Dwarves! Dwarves!
All right, stand by for a moment. I'm too fast there. Gosh, Sedalia, you didn't know about Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, honey.
You did. You just drew a blank on it, though. Well, listen, you can't be too unhappy because you got a total of $5,600.
It's great meeting you.
It was lovely.
Thank you, Sedalia. Goodbye, my dear. Sedalia Jones, there she goes.
Goodbye, Sedalia.
Why did you get work?
How quickly did you get it?
Yes. How tall are you?
5'9".
You're a nice, tall lady. Okay, here we
are,
folks. Very
good Sydney Green Street impression.
Yes. I now pronounce you... Well, it's about time. All right, Alan Rowe. We'll have a go now at over $5,000. We polled a recent studio audience, Ellen, and we got their best response to this. Blank moose. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, and $250 and $100. Whom do you call her?
Richard.
Bull.
Oh, really? Well, what's your answer?
Bull.
Bull moose. Okay.
And Betty, please.
Betty?
Bullwinkle.
Bullwinkle moose?
Yes.
Excuse me a second. Get the hell out of here.
Bullwinkle moose. Okay.
What's a bull?
Well, I don't know. It's up to you. If you say bullwinkle moose, that's it.
Bullwinkle moose.
Charles, please.
Chocolate.
Yeah. Very good.
So spelling sure doesn't count with that. Sure don't count there. Neither does grammar, and nothing counts here. All right, so you got chocolate mousse or chocolate there. You got the bull, and then you got the bull winkle.
I'll go with chocolate.
Oh, no.
Really?
No. What?
Well, I'm a little worried about it. All right, we'll find out if it's up there. Let's go down to the bottom, begin with the $100 response and looking for chocolate mousse. Oh, you got it. Congratulations, my dear. Mousse au chocolat. What do you got under the 250? Roll it. Bullwinkle. All right, Betty, you're vindicated. Last chance here. Let me see what you got there. Whoa.
Alan, why don't you try?
They're all three up there. Now, Ellen, you're up to $200. You're going to be playing for $1,000. But first, we got to stop and do a little business, America. Here we go. See you right here, Match Game 75. Goodbye.
Production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.